Annual Student Awards for the 2021-22 academic year. My name is Karen Redhead and I'm the Principal and CEO of West London College. It's a great pleasure and a privilege to be here tonight, and I'm delighted that you could join us to celebrate some of the high achievements of the college and our students from last year. I'd like to start by welcoming our nominated students and their families, our invited partners, guests, our staff and board members. Thank you very much for joining us tonight for this special celebratory event. I would also like to say a special welcome and thank you to our sponsors for this evening, Best Practice People, Protocol and Three Drakes. Our mission is to inspire learning and improve lives through education, training and skills development, supporting social and economic success of our learners, businesses, and the wider communities across West London. And we are guided by our college values of ambition, innovation, accountability, and inclusion. The awards are a celebration of our mission and values, recognising the individual talent and the hard work and determination the students have shown. It's also an opportunity to recognise the role that our strategic partners play in helping to positively shape the lives of our students. Before we hear more about these achievements, I want to spend a few minutes reflecting on some successes of the last academic year. And whilst we do this, we should also be mindful that the college and our students that are receiving awards tonight have managed to achieve these successful outcomes while still dealing with the impact of the pandemic, which continued to be disruptive last year. Throughout the last academic year, we celebrated the success of our Women into Construction programmes, training up all women groups in a variety of trade skills and supporting them to progress into good work. Working in partnership with the charity Women into Construction, we've supported over 50 women into a variety of construction-related roles across the year. The programme proved so successful that Channel 5 News had to come and see for themselves the work that was being undertaken by so many successful and ambitious students. We also held a special construction and green skills event to promote these sectors to women on International Women's Day in March. And later in the year, we received the Women into Construction Partnerships with Purpose 2022 Award in recognition of the work we do to combat the gender imbalance in the construction industry. We were equally honoured to receive the West London Business Award of Education and Training Provider of the Year for our work on the Mayor's Construction Academy, and were presented with the award at an event at Twickenham Stadium by former British tennis player, now radio and TV presenter, Annabelle Croft. We were delighted to be awarded trailblazing status from the Race Equality Matters for our hashtag My Name Is campaign that you may have seen around our college buildings. This campaign was designed to help everyone pronounce people's names correctly by using phonetic spelling in email signatures and written documents, Our campaign at college also encourages openness in presenting people's chosen pronouns, introducing another way to acknowledge and respect each and every member of the college community. For Pride Month, some of our students took part in the Elephant LGBTQ Plus and Inclusion Art Competition. Elephant is a magazine, online art shop and art academy with an ethos to inspire every artist. Two of our students, Zainab Zidane and Malachi John, were awarded prizes in the competition, with both students having their artwork displayed at the Elephant Space next to White City Tube Station. We've also created mini displays with Zainab and Malachi's work across our colleges. Continuing our award-winning year, another of our students, Eliana Gola, was named the overall winner of the London Metropolitan University's Big Writing Challenge at the prestigious offices of Orion Publishing. Eliana's short story was selected the overall winner by the publishing director at Orion, Emad Akhtar. In June, our inclusive learning football team won the FA Supported Learning College League for 2021-22, run by Brentford FC Community Trust. The team were presented with their trophy at Gillette Corner Goals. Throughout the tournament, the five-a-side squad continued their almost unbeaten run to the season, defeated in only one of their 18 games. They scored 32 goals in total and conceded just 9, earning a whopping 43 points, which was 21 points clear of the league runner-up. One of our team, Abubakar Adam, who played in midfield, was also named player of the tournament. You may be aware that we're currently redeveloping part of our Southall Community College into a brand new state-of-the-art construction and green skills centre designed with employers to ensure generations to come in the area have access to the latest equipment and facilities for training in this growth sector. In June, the Mayor of London recognised our commitment to delivering this training by awarding West London College the Mayor's Academies Programme Quality Mark for Construction, Green Skills and Health and Social Care. And Deputy Mayor Jules Pipe visited us at Southall Community College to present the college with the awards. This new accreditation recognises high-quality training meets the needs of London's employers, supports Londoners into good jobs, and the work we are doing to achieve this. We continued into the second year of our innovative partnership with the Fair Shot Cafe, which has gone from strength to strength. The partnership provides excellent opportunities for our young people with disabilities to develop careers in the hospitality and catering sector. Fairshot Cafe not only helps our students to develop the necessary skills, but it also builds confidence and provides a huge boost to their self-esteem and well-being. This success was recognised last year when the BBC News team came to visit to see the amazing work for themselves. We've also been able to support the good work of local charities by offering space at our Hammersmith College for a food bank warehouse and by providing space to West London Welcome to support their excellent work with refugees, migrants and people seeking asylum. Indeed, the work of West London Welcome has achieved a very high profile, including a visit last year from King Charles III before he acceded to the throne. We will shortly move on to the awards themselves, but before we do that, I would like to take this opportunity to showcase the breadth, depth and diversity of the work we do at the college. So during 2021-22, West London College delivered programmes to over 10,000 students, and we worked with over 600 different employers. We trained around 300 adults in employability skills to progress into work, and had around 400 apprentices studying on over 30 different apprenticeship standards. And whilst the majority of our students are based in West London, we also deliver training further afield to over 3,000 students through distance learning programmes, and we worked with strategic partners to deliver in the Southwest, the Midlands and the Northwest. These examples, I believe, illustrate that our strategy to focus on employability and to expand our services to employers continues to be extremely successful, and it's very pleasing to see the excellent reputation that we've gained as a result. In conclusion, I would personally like to thank two groups whose ongoing support has been vital to our success. I would like to thank the staff at West London College for their unwavering dedication to helping our students achieve truly amazing outcomes. They are the heroes, the role models and the mentors who provide life-changing experiences to our students every day. And also, the college would not have achieved this success without the challenge and support of its board. So thank you to our college board members for their ongoing dedication, considerable expertise and their invaluable challenge and support. Please can we show our appreciation for our staff and board members with a round of applause. I'd also like to say a special thank you at this stage to Kiva, who's providing the signing for us this evening. Delighted to introduce one of our current Level 3 Public Services students, and she's also one of the award nominees this evening. So Anna Hanvey, Anna, please can you come down to the stage? Anna is going to share her inspirational story with us. So please give a round of applause for her.
This year's guest speaker for West London College's award ceremony. I just moved over to London just over a year ago from Harrogate, North Yorkshire, as I hope to become a detective in the Metropolitan Police. London seems to be the most exciting place to work and study, and I found West London College and was very impressed by the teachers and its surroundings. During my time at this college, the teachers have supported me greatly, helping me grow and develop a wide range of skills that I need to start my career, and for that I am very grateful. I've developed more than just my course. I've developed skills in critical thinking, leadership, communication, teamwork, and of course, a high level of personal fitness. I aspire to give back to the community and do something worthwhile, and in February next year, I'm going to Gambia for 2 weeks to help renovate classrooms for children, and I'll also be working with Gambian counterparts and also helping families prepare meals in their homes, and also getting an insight in their culture as well by visiting the local markets. I'll be completing my gold residential and volunteering elements of my Gold Youth Labour Award, and I'll be completing an ASDEN qualification volunteering whilst I'm there as well. I'm currently fundraising money to go towards my Gambia trip, and if you'd like to donate, you can find more information on the college's website. Again, I'd like to say thank you to the college staff for opportunities they've given me and given us all to us fellow nominees tonight. And good luck to everyone nominated for an award, and thank you again.
Thank you, Anna, for sharing your inspirational story with us. So it's the time we've all been waiting for. We'll now begin presenting the awards of the evening. We did have many nominations submitted this year, and the judges had a very difficult task choosing the overall winners. Getting through to the final nomination stage this evening makes you all winners in our eyes, and I think you all yourselves deserve a huge round of applause. This evening by welcoming Charles Nelson, Assistant Principal, to the stage. Whoa.
Okay, good evening everybody. Our first awards tonight are college-based awards for excellence. The nominees for our Hammersmith and Fulham College 16 to 18 Award for Excellence are Raquel Amida. Woo! logo. Our next award is also for Hammersmith and Fulham College and is our award for excellence recognising our outstanding adult students. The nominees are Yanani Azanza. Teacher as consistently motivated and hard working, whose enthusiasm for studying and learning helps other students in their class. They help establish a study group in the library, encouraging others to join further to improve their English, as well as volunteering for other college activities. Over the course of their course, they improved in competence, both in speaking English and establishing a friendship network, and have been an inspiration to others. Okay, the winner, the award for excellence adult, is Cecilia Hendren.
The nominees are Tiza E. Divar, Elena Omar Itani, and Kabul. The winner of this category is an award winner that you might recognize from earlier. Representing Western and College at the Big Writing Challenge, their short story was awarded first place. They have continued to explore both written and creative art skills and have applied to study fine art at Oxford University. In addition to their excellence in their studies with us, they are also a college student rep, helping their classmates, and in the wider community are a member of the Quest Theatre Company. Kind, friendly, and engaging, they are a pleasure to teach. So, any guesses? But I will. It's Elena Fular. Last year, where they achieved a distinction as well as achieving their target grade for GCSE maths. In addition to their academic achievements, they are active in the college community, volunteering to represent the college during open events and more. They balance their commitment to the college and their studies with the responsibility as a full-time parent and overcame a significant amount of adversity in the past year. Their determination and resilience is inspirational to the rest of the class. The winner is Parvana Ahmed.
Community College and Park Royal College Award for Excellence are Ahmed Al-Rajah. The winner of this award has excelled in their studies. Since they joined Suffolk Community College, they've consistently produced outstanding outcomes and they model inspiring standards of commitment and hard work to their peers. This was reflected in them achieving distinctions in their studies with us, an achievement which they can be truly proud of. So let's check in my special envelope. So it's not like the Oscars, but what? That's Billy Mooney!
So tell us that Billy's not here then.
Yeah, that's why Gareth's picking up the award.
But the people here don't know.
He's not Billy. He's not Billy. We did say that. Yeah, so Billy's Billy. Yeah.
For Billy.
Excellence Award for Sackville Community College and Park Royal Colleges. The nominees are John Joe Unfortunately, again, Sadia can't be with us, and Sadia Naz is the big winner.
So
she's here!
As the winner of this award, a great determination in applying their college studies to securing full-time employment as a teaching assistant in a local school. Congratulations. They showed great diligence in their studies, acting as a role model to their classmates and inspiring all our future students to say they can get jobs. And it's wonderful for you, Sadia. Thank you so much.
I've got a number of awards to give out tonight. So the first one is the Apprentice of the Year Award. This category is one clear winner, Sally Ishag. One of our last. Sally completed her supported internship at Hammersmith and Fulham College following an inclusive apprenticeship as a receptionist at the Royal Borough of Kensington and Chelsea Council. Completing her apprenticeship, Sally progressed onto a role at 245 Hammersmith as a receptionist. Celebrating those who study a course level 4 or above. Mansour Iduma, who studied at level 5 HE in health and care practice. Mansour trained as a computer systems analyst in Sudan, but found it difficult to work in the IT field when he came to the UK 27 years ago. He worked in hospitality and accountants. He also found his passion in helping people doing some volunteering work at St. Mungo's charity. He decided to develop his skills in health and social care and enrolled on health and social care level 1 to familiarise himself within the subject before progressing straight onto the HND, a huge achievement. After completing the course, Mansour started at Regent's College in London, where he's studying for a 1-year top-up to a full BSc in health and social care. Mansour even plans to go on to study a master's qualification. We're pleased to welcome Mansour here tonight. Yes, we're pleased to welcome you.
I'm really glad to be here standing in front of you. For those few words, I want to say education is a continuous learning process from the day we born until we pass. any day passes without learning or knowledge or getting more skills, that is a waste. Mm-hmm. And please keep education, education, education. Thank you so much.
SEND Student of the Year. And our nominees are Myra Dabouk, Bethany El Labak, Megan Murphy, and winning this award excelled in their supported internship at the University of West London, never allowing their learning difficulty to impede their enthusiasm and drive. They worked hard to complete their studies, as well as gaining skills in interview techniques, work experience and self-development. Their classmates described them as being kind, confident and an advocate, helping with their interview techniques and job searching, eventually becoming class rep. They secured work at Heathrow before applying to be a customer service apprenticeship at West London College in the student recruitment and marketing teams. They've been involved in helping set up tonight's celebrations. Oh. And the winner is Megan Murphy. Students of the year, someone aged 14 to 16 studying with us. Our two nominees are Saleh Al-Tebe and Elisa Ho, both very determined and successful in their studies. The winner of this award shows great determination to do well, asking questions and seeking every opportunity to achieve their best grades possible. They would often stay on after school to do extra work, including additional research and reading to help them succeed. Always willing to help their classmates, they even set up their own science study sessions with others to help them succeed. This hard work paid off, and they achieved grade 9 in maths and science,
Woo.
Grade 8 in English and sociology,
Woo.
Grade 7 in RE. Yeah. Incredible set of results. And the winner is Alisa Poe.
So the nominees are Miriam Banani, members of the Union and Southport Inclusive Learning Faculty. So the winner of this award has successfully overcome many personal challenges to succeed at West London College, where we were able to give them a fresh start to fulfil their potential. They've gone on to demonstrate model behaviour and a great work ethic, achieving a distinction in functional anatomy and a merit grade in sports psychology exams this year. They have a passion for football, and they're part of our football academy in partnership with Hounslow Women's Football Club, an inspiration to other players and their classmates. They are fearless in their tackle and encourage others to break through gender stereotypes in sport. They're currently completing UCAS applications, and I'm sure they'll have great success at university. And so the winner is Miriam Banani. the leader of sports, Liam, will accept on the line. We're incredibly proud of all our employer and community partners. They work with us to offer opportunities for young people in West London. We'd like to once again thank our sponsors and the employers who have joined us here tonight. There were two outstanding employers who worked with us extensively this past year. The nominees for Employer or Community Partner of the Year are Red Carnation Hotels and the Metropolitan Police. Over the past year, this evening's winner has sent staff to deliver career sessions to our students, introducing them to a wide variety of jobs available in the sector. They work with our students to help them join an independent youth advice group, ensuring young people's voices are heard in decision-making. They've also supported our learners with pastoral care, delivering important workshops on knife crime, racism, county lines, prevent. They've even brought along some specialists to speak to our students. This partnership has helped to build better relationships between our students and the police, helping them understand that you don't just need to interact with police when you're in trouble. You might be able to guess who's won this without me having in the envelope. But the winner is the Metropolitan Police. Outstanding employers offering work placements to our students, helping us to help them develop the skills they need for the workplace. So our next award is for Work Placement Employer of the Year. The nominations are the British Heart Foundation, Eclectic, and Red Carnation Hotels. The winner of our Work Placement Employer of the Year is the It's a live music program of a community interest company that reaches out to several venues with performances from musicians. They've supported our students by providing a variety of work experience opportunities, offering placements in social media, design, marketing, and many more things. They've supported and accommodated students consistently, and we're really grateful to be working with them for their collaboration. The winner is Ealing Eclectic.
Say thank you as well to Louise Scully, who was working with us on the project. She sort of worked well with the students, and basically you can go and find the work online at Ealing Club Eclectic if you look up on Google. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Fantastic. I'd like to hand over to Maxine Deslond, Director of Finance, to introduce our next award.
Chris, and good evening, everybody. The first award I have the pleasure of presenting is our Inclusive Learning Student Award. The nominees are Abu Bakar Adnan, Angelo Demab, Kieran Royal, Jamil Wellington. Woo! The winner of this award was part of our Ealing Green and South Hall Inclusive Learning Team during the last league, where they finished at the top of the FE-supported Learning College League for 21-22. Throughout the tournament, the five-a-side squad continued their almost unbeaten run to season, defeating only one of 18 games. Whilst the entire team were hugely successful, this award winner shone in their position playing in midfield, being played named Player of the Tournament. The winner is Abu Bakar Adam. Is our ambitious student of the year. The nominees are Hanaya Direch, Sean McHugh, Na Wing, and Tiffany and Aldrina Vass. The winner of this award has shown great ambition and is an inspiration to others, coming to the UK alone in 2018 as a refugee aged 15. In 2021, aged 18, they joined West London College to study for health and social care, achieving distinctions all round, equivalent to achieving 3 A-stars at A-level. In November 2021, they took part in a work placement with the Imperial College National Health Trust, which led to a job offer as a healthcare assistant. During this employment, they met NHS osteopaths and decided to train to become a chiropractor. They started a four-year chiropractic integrated master's degree at London's South Bank University in September 2022 and hoped to set up their own clinic in the future. The winner is Hanaya Dindis. Loved member of our community, a trailblazer who inspired and continues to inspire all of us at West London College. Throughout everything that he achieved, from his entrepreneurial success to charity work, Jamal Edwards, MBE, maintained his links with the college and worked tirelessly to positively impact the West London community. The Jamal Edwards MBE Contribution to the Community Award acknowledges those who have made a visible impact in their communities following in Jamal's footsteps. The nominees are Muhammad Ali Ali Jali and Anna Hanvi. The winner of this award moved from Yorkshire to London to study public services at West London College so they can pursue a dream career in the Met Police. An active member of the Hammersmith and Fulham Police Cadets, they take part in a variety of voluntary work to help and give back to the community. They regularly take part in a variety of competitions and later this month will be helping with the Remembrance Parade at the Cenotaph in central London this month. In addition, they are currently awaiting rank status from the cadets and will be doing their gold status Duke of Edinburgh Award next year. In February 2023, they will be volunteering in Gambia, renovating classrooms and helping families cook meals. The winner is, you met her earlier, Anna Hanvi. We have one last award, so I'd like to hand back to Karen Redhead to present the Principals Award 2022. Thank you, Max.
So I hope you'll agree with me that all of the award winners we've met tonight are hugely inspirational and we couldn't be more proud of them. This final award, the Principals Award, is where we select the overall winner from all of the winners we've recognised this evening. You've heard all of their citations and stories, so I'm sure you'll recognise that this was a really difficult choice indeed. However, I am delighted to announce that the winner of the Principals Award for 2022 is it's Miriam Benani. She's not able to join us this evening, so Liam will be accepting the award on her behalf. Thank you. Event to a close. We hope you've had a great time celebrating with us tonight. We'd love it if award winners could please assemble back on the stage so we can get an official group photograph. And that leaves me only to say thank you again very much for coming. Have a safe journey home and good night.